I'm They say, welcome to our warm-up. Please sit comfortably. Please turn off the sound of your mobile phones in order to be here, present. They will scroll over this text while as you follow this experience. Choreographing the screen, jumping lines, shifting positions, and turning pages. They will experiment with the things you can and cannot see, as well as the ones you wanted or not to see. Because things are where they are. Because things are how they are. Because of variant ideas disrupting one out of nine possibilities. They are an entanglement of channels. This experience is an entanglement of channels. They are in real life. They are online. This experience will exist in the during, in the while, in the now, as they exist. Can you see they? A rhizomatic intertwining of bodies, experiences, things. Feel free to join they in the channel of your preference. Feel free to join they in all the channels. Feel free to not join they at all. They prepare to fail. They fail to prepare. As we read and speak, they recommend you to stay tuned and follow it live together. They will propose movement. They will propose participation. Feel free to join or not to join. They believe in engaging. They believe in engaging in this experience. They suggest to start experiencing from the body. Body as matter. What bodies matter? They suggest today to start experiencing from the materiality of the body and to go flexible. They suggest to surpass matter as something fixed. They propose flexibility. They will navigate different tactics in progress, starting from greater than one, body space, body, body language, body, body rhizome, body, body four, body, body collective, body collective, body collective, collective, I collective, body, they, body, you, I, they. Who are they? Pause. They believe in engaging. They believe in engaging in this experience. They believe in the experience that starts now. Or a few minutes ago, or a long time ago. Pause. Come with me. Breathe in. Acknowledge your body in the space. Breathe in. Do you see other bodies? Breathe in. Where are these bodies in space? Breathe out. Do you feel the warmth of the light touching your skin? Breathe out. Do you feel the light of the spot in your cheeks? Breathe in. Do you feel the light of your screen in your face? Breathe out. Close your eyes for 1 second. What do you see? Breathe in. Pause. Can you see the space between us? Breathe out. Pause. Is there any movement between us? Breathe out. Pause. Can you fill in the space between us? Breathe out. Open your eyes. What do you see? Breathe in. Can you see the space between us? Breathe in. Pause. Slowly return to your breathing rhythm as we continue. They identify themselves with today's act, a collective occupation of the several channels to meet each other and intertwine our experiences. They perceive this gathering of singularities as a collective act. They see the potentialities of performance to experiment collectiveness in an attempt to make it singular, fluid, and unpredictable experience. They believe in the experience that starts now, or a few minutes ago, maybe a long time ago. You, I, they. Who are they?
Not quite sure which ones are working here, so we'll just pretend we know. je suis très contente d'être ici. Je voudrais remercier tous les gens qui ont travaillé pour établir l'événement ici. I know it took an enormous amount of work, and I've rarely come across such a beautifully organized and well thought through program as this one. So
what I'm saying, actually, you see, I mean, it's a combination of all.
Reconnaissant, I mean, very grateful and mindful that so much has been done here, and I thank you all.
Not if you have one to the extreme, you will be very unscientific. If you have another to the extreme, you become all of a sudden a mechanical man.
They find an interstice in Butler's words to achieve a collective body.
What is called gender identity is a performative accomplishment compiled by social sanction and taboo. In its very character as performative resides the possibility of contesting its reified status.
Yes, this is day's cue. Flexibility presents itself where facticity is contested, allowing us to perceive the body as flexible.
Be formless, shapeless, like water. Now you put water into a cup, it becomes the cup. You put water into a bottle, it becomes the bottle. You put it in a teapot, it becomes the teapot. Now water can flow or it can crash. Be water, my friend.
Friends,
they want to become water.
Friends, they experiment with the nuances of combining
collective greater than one to the body equals one.
We,
they
could be a body,
a collective
body, a body greater than,
bigger than one,
greater than one,
beyond one,
beyond one,
beyond one.
It's recording already.
But you have a nice colors.
Yeah.
A nice palette.
And we didn't come in. I don't know.
Color coordinated.
We didn't arrange it.
Good.
All right.
Good morning.
Good morning.
So today is your big working day.
For some time now, I have been getting into trouble with my use of we and us in my texts. Frequently after the pub. For some time now, I have been getting into trouble with my use of we and us in my texts. Frequently after the publication of some piece, I would be asked, often with great hostility, who is we? Who are us in your writing? We, they would say, who don't share your identity, be it national, sexual, political, theoretical, class, or language-based. Refuse our inclusion into your argument. Well, the we I have in mind is not identity-based. It cannot be found in the named categories by which an identity is currently recognized in the world.
Boom, 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 boom.
None of the above are in any way lamentable or invalid modes of inhabiting the spaces of contemporary art, but they do limit us to a kind of frontal relation which continues to pose the work of art at the center of all processes of producing meaning. By introducing the notion of we as central to the experience of art, I am insisting on several elements.
On the fact that meaning is never produced in isolation or through isolating processes, but rather through intricate webs of connectedness.
On the fact that audiences produce meaning not simply through the subjectivities they project on art works whose circuits of meanings they complete, but that they produce meaning through relations with one another and through the temporality of the event of the exhibition or the display.
On the fact that art works and thematic exhibitions that continue to reproduce them into view do not have immanent meanings, but function as fields of possibilities for different audiences in different cultural circumstances and widely divergent moods to produce significances.
on the fact that in a reflective shift from the analytical to the performative function of observation and of participation, we can agree that meaning is not excavated for, but that it takes place in the present.
Perhaps here, as a point of contact, might be precisely the understanding that what we call the I, and what we seem to sometimes, under contemporary conditions of individualism, what we sometimes understand as the seat or source of action, is itself comes out of something that is more vast and more relational, and it also dissolves back into it, not just with coming into life and passing from life, although certainly there, but also within life, as what might even be understood to be a recurrent kind of process. And that does mean taking a perspective on the I, the sovereign I, from somewhere else, that it does not presume that I as a pure center of control or mastery, and that I think that is.
Hey, I'm Miles. I'm part of the choreography team here on the Spice World 2019 tour. So we're gonna start. Swing round to the left, big hip swing. Swing it, you jump. Shake it, head, move it, arm, make it. Who do you think you are? Shimmy and four steps. We grab it, you touch it, you groove it, you push it. Who do you think you are?
This scene is a chronological parkour of the ongoing construction of Researcher Greater Than One. Through dialogues with the Advisory Committee, the Academy of Fine Arts, and our beloved collaborators. The scene is a series of movements and passages from our archive, the digital real and in real life. Currently, they are addressing the following issues.
One, two, three.
Who are they?
Who are they?
How do researcher greater than one perform? Do researcher greater than one have autonomy?
They believe that certain acts reinforce collectiveness. Example given, the use of pronouns to name ourselves or others involved by performing with the use of they instead of we. How to create a collective act, acknowledging the singularities involved in it? Furthermore, how can an act be collective without getting lost in individualities? How to avoid unwanted or unrespectful participation in a collective act? They will run through these questions in a tryout to avoid certain problematic acts that have already been identified, like totalitarianism or uniformity.
This moment, we open the mic from the ones who are here and who are on stage with us. So your mic should be open by now. And we open, well, it's already open, but the chat box of the collaborators who are home, we will be reading at the same time. We will be passing a video that you should also be able to watch through the streaming with our research parkour that we just spoke about. And we will be commenting, and you are free to comment together with us.
Thank you, Ruul, Miriam, to be here with us.
Thank you, Juliana, Jonas, Ria, Nico.
Okay. So this footage...
Kathleen.
Kathleen on stage also. Lotte. So this footage is a tryout of a method we are
developing. Zoom.
Okay.
Should I take off my backup audio now?
Yes.
Okay.
So this footage, the
audio settings of Zoom. Sorry, it's a lot of technical systems at the same time. The echo stopped.
Yes, I mute the sound of, you don't need music
anymore. No.
Perfect.
Thank you so much. Sorry. So, well, now we're on the website of the Academy and the Conservatoire.
This is the image of the rhizome that represents our researcher greater than one. We a bit three-dimensionalized over here on the stage. This was part of, we did in collaboration with Lotte, also the text of Researcher Greater Than One. The image was done with Erika.
Erika Hitcoat, yes.
And the Researcher Greater Than One was created because we thought that when we were exposing our research in the website, it felt weird to only have two researchers as authors of this research when there was so many more things, people... objects involved, and Researcher Greater Than One existed and started to get life because of that.
And since we developed the image and Researcher Greater Than One, we had been in constant dialogue with our advisory committee, that the members are the ones that are here present with us. I don't know if someone wants to make a comment.
No, for now, no, they still didn't. No, it's okay. These are a few of the notes we made also during our residency in Brussels, Inhabiting Collectiveness, which we will present a bit more of the material later. We have also some notes with a meeting with Nico and also with Kathleen. So this is a bit of a build-up. We do this build-up in constant dialogues, which is also what Research Greater Than One represents, this rhizomatic dialogues. That's how we call it for now.
Did you explain already the use of they?
Yeah, no, you can do that.
Okay, so now we are emailing and communicating with the use of they because we think that is the most accurate way of, not explaining, but showing the multiplicity of people that are engaged in this project and things. But actually, we had some questions. We were questioned on the use of they and how we were performing, so now we try to invite the collaborators, and if we were able to have audience, the audience will be with us on stage to kind of rhizomize with us.
Yeah, and for instance, this videos of us dancing, it's one of, in the beginning we had, so we started with a theory of Butler on this project, we are still on it, and one of the reasons we were trying to present other ways of reading and rehearsing, and we came up a bit with a tactics called RRR, reading, rehearsing, researching, which is experimentations on the body with reading at the same time, so you can see us twerking while we are reading and some other things that we do. It's a bit one of the tactics also we developed so far.
Yeah, together with Researcher Greater Than One. Okay.
Yeah, so we spoke a lot, but I don't know if you have anything else to address or... You're not, you don't have to, huh? It's
good. Okay, we continue then.
Also, they have a delay.
Yeah.
That's also a pity. They only hear us, I think, 40 seconds.
Your microphone, it has to be over. I think that's coming in something. Zoom your microphone.
I close Zoom. Okay.
All right.
We go to the next scene.
We go to the next scene.
You run the sun? Oh.
me, Hugo. Hugo, no, Chris, sorry. Unmute my
sound
computer.
Here from the computer.
Hashtag M8, shed light on women and dissidents, because today is Women International Strike Day, because we identify as women or dissidents.
They ask for all collaborators or participants present today in the digital real or in real life that identify themselves as women or dissidents, please turn lights on to themselves.